हेलो फ्रेंड्स, केजी क्लासेस में आपका स्वागत है। आज हम आपको जॉफ्री चौसर के लॉन्ग आंसर के बारे में बताएंगे। क्वेश्चन है, राइट ए क्रिटिकल नोट ऑन द प्लान एंड द पर्पस ऑफ द प्रोलॉग टू द कैंटरबरी टेल्स। आंसर हेडिंग है प्लान। द प्रोलॉग इज सो इंटरेस्टिंग बिकॉज इट सजेस्ट द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ द कैंटरबरी टेल्स एंड पेंट्स ए पिक्चर ऑफ नेशनल लाइफ। बैकेनियोस डे कैमेरन वाज एन एग्जाम्पल टू चौसर, बट चौसर गोज बियॉन्ड हिज मॉडल एंड गिव्स ए न्यू सिग्निफिकेंस टू हिज वर्क एंड बाई हिज इंसाइट एंड परसेप्शन। बाई हिज जीनियल ह्यूमर एंड ह्यूमनिज्म इन द प्रोलॉग द पोएट रिप्रेजेंट्स हिमसेल्फ एज एलाइटनिंग वन स्प्रिंग इवनिंग एट द टेबर्ट टेवर्ड इन साउथ बार, ए सबर्ब एट द साउथर्न एंड ऑफ लंदन ब्रिज, वेयर लेटर द फेमस एलिजाबेथन प्ले हाउसेस शेक्सपियर्स एमंग देम, वेयर द स्प्रिंग ऑफ साउथ बर्क वाज द प्लेस ऑफ डिपार्चर एंड अराइवल फॉर ऑल साउथ ऑफ इंग्लैंड ट्रेवल एंड स्पेशलिटी ऑफ फोर पिलग्रिमेज टू द श्राइन ऑफ एसटी थॉमस ए बैकेट एट कैंटरबरी। ए कंपनी सेटिंग आउट ऑन सच ए पिलग्रिमेज गैदर इन चौसर मेक्स देयर एक्वेंटेंस एंड फॉर्म्स वन ऑफ द पार्टी। द पिलग्रिम्स आर फेयर 32 इन ऑल इंक्लूडिंग द पोएट। देयर इज ए नाइट लेटली कम फ्रॉम फॉरेन बार्स, ही हैज फॉट इन प्रूसिया एंड टर्की, जेस्टेड इन ट्रेमिसेन एंड बीन प्रेजेंट एट द स्टोर्मिंग ऑफ अलेक्जेंड्रिया। ए हाई माइंडेड जेंटल मैनर्ड नाइटली एडवेंचरर, ए टाइप ऑफ द कर्टियस बार लविंग सेवेलरस पर्सन हुज क्लास बार वाज रैपिडली डिस अपीयरिंग विद हिम ए इन हिज सन ए यंग स्क्वायर करली हेयर्ड एंड गे हिज शॉर्ट वाइट स्लीव्ड गॉन एम्ब्रॉयडर्ड लाइक ए मैड विद रेड एंड वाइट फ्लावर्स ही सम्स अप इन हिमसेल्फ द गिफ्ट एंड ग्रेसेस ऑफ ए ब्रिलियंट यूथ। द सर्वेंट इज ए ह्यूमन इन कोट एंड हुड ऑफ ग्रीन, ए सेफ ऑफ पीकॉक एरो अंडर हिज बेल्ट, ए माइटी बो इन हिज हैंड एंड सिल्वर इमेजेज ऑफ सेंट क्रिस्टोफर अपॉन हिज ब्रीस्ट। ही इज द टाइप ऑफ दैट स्टडी इंग्लिश यूमैनरी विच विद इट्स ग्रे गूस सेफ्स हम्बल्ड द प्राइड ऑफ फ्रांस ग्रेसी एंड एगिन कोड। देयर इज ए होल ग्रुप ऑफ इक्लेस्टिकल फिगर्स रिप्रेजेंटिंग द डिफरेंट इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द मेडिवल चर्च, मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर सटायरिकल पोर्ट्रेट्स एक्सपोजिंग इन देयर वर्ल्डलीनेस एंड मटेरियलिज्म द अब्यूजेज विद विच हैड क्रेप्ट इन टू द चर्च एंड विच By clip denounced first of all, there is a monk who cares only for hunting and good cares. His bald head shines like glass, his bright eyes roll in his head, he drives a sleek brown palfrey and has many a dainty horse in his stables. His sleeves are trimmed with fur at the wrist. His hood is fastened under his chin with a gold love knot. Another figure joining the party aid is Madame Eglantine, the prioress. She is the teacher of young ladies speaking French after the school of Stratford at a ball. She is exquisite in her table manners, affecting as well as she can the stately behavior of the court. Other इक्लेस्टिस्टिक्स आर हंगर्स ऑन एंड कैटरपिलर्स ऑफ द चर्च ही द फ्रायर इंटीमेट विद हॉस्पिटेबल फ्रैंकलाइन इन कीपर्स एंड वर्दी वुमेन एंड डिपोजिंग बेगर्स एंड लेजर द समनर रिपल्सिव पर्सन विद फायर रेड चेयरविन फेस द पार्डोनर विद हिज बैग फुल ऑफ पार्डन्स कम फ्रॉम रोम ऑल हॉट एंड बिट्स ऑफ क्लॉथ एंड फिक्स बोन्स विच ही सेल्स एज रिलिक्स ऑफ होली सेंट चौसर ट्रीट्स द इवेल चर्चमैन विद गुड ह्यूमर्ड टॉलरेंस ही प्रोड्यूसेस ए बेटर इफेक्ट बाय सेटिंग बिसाइड देम एज ए टाइप ऑफ द ट्रू शेफर्ड ऑफ द चर्च ए पुअर पर्सन सच एज पार्टली अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंसेस ऑफ वाइटक्लिफ वाज कमिंग फॉरवर्ड टू रिफॉर्म द चर्च चौसर पेंट्स द करेक्टर ऑफ द पर्सन पुअर इन द वर्ल्ड गुड बट रिच ऑफ होली थॉट्स एंड वर्क विद ए लविंग एंड रिवरेंट टच द पर्सन्स ब्रदर ट्रेवल विद हिम ए प्लोमैन ए ट्रू स्विंकर एंड ए गुड हु हेल्प्स हिज पुअर नेबर्स विदाउट हायर एंड लव्स देम एज हिमसेल्फ ही रिमाइंड्स अस ऑफ पियर्स एंड प्लोमैन ए क्राउड ऑफ अदर फिगर इज देयर टू फिल द कैनवास देयर इज ए शिपमैन फ्रॉम द बेस्ट कंट्री ए रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ दोज एडवेंचरस सरमन सीमैन हाफ अर्चेंट सेलर्स हाफ स्मगलर्स एंड पिरेट्स हु हैड ऑलरेडी मेड इंग्लैंड नेम ए टेरर ऑन द हाई सीज एंड पेव्ड द वे फॉर हर फ्यूचर नेवल एंड कॉमर्शियल सुप्रीमेसी देयर इज ए पुअर किलर ऑफ ऑक्सफोर्ड राइडिंग ए हॉर्स एज लीन एज ए रैक एंड ड्रेस्ड इन थ्रेडवेयर क्लॉक्स हु स्पेंड ऑल दैट ही कैन बैग और बोरो अपॉन हिज स्टडीज ही रिप्रेजेंट्स दैट पैशन फॉर लर्निंग विच वॉज स्टीरिंग एवरीवेयर इन यूरोप एंड विच वॉज टू कल्मिनेट इन द रेनेसेंस देयर इज ए मर्चेंट इन ए फ्लेमिश बीवर हैट ऑन ए हाई हॉर्स कंसीलिंग एज ही कैन विद हिज एयर ऑफ सेल्फ इम्पोर्टेंस द फैक्ट दैट ही इज इन डेप्ट देयर इज ए ग्रुप ऑफ गाइड मेंबर इन द लाइब्रेरी ऑफ देयर गाइड ऑल वर्दी टू बी एल्डरमैन दे अलोंग विद द मर्चेंट रिप्रेजेंट्स द मर्केंटाइल एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग क्लास दे पॉइंट टू द फ्यूचर राइज ऑफ इंग्लैंड एज ए ग्रेट कॉमर्शियल पावर देयर इज ए वाइफ ऑफ बाथ ऑलमोस्ट ए मॉडर्न फेमिनिस्ट फिगर हिट ऑफ विद मास्टरली ह्यूमर एंड रियलिज्म ए परमानेंट ह्यूमन टाइप सी हैज वेड हस्बैंड फाइव एट चर्च डोर एंड दो सोमडेल डीप होप्स टू लिव टू बेड सीवरल अदर्स सी राइड्स ऑन एन एम्बलर विद स्पर एंड स्कारलेट हॉर्स ऑन हर फीट एंड ऑन हर हेड ए हैट एज ब्रॉड एज ए बकलर इन फैक्ट दे रिप्रेजेंट्स द इंटायर रेंज ऑफ इंग्लिश सोसाइटी ऑफ द 14th सेंचुरी लिविंग आउट ओनली द हाइएस्ट अरिस्टोक्रेसी एंड द लोवेस्ट ऑर्डर ऑफ ब्लेन और सर्फ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन है डिस्कस चौसर्स आर्ट ऑफ करेक्टर पोर्ट्रेयल और द चौसर ऑफ करेक्टर ऑफ चौसर्स पिलग्रिम्स आर द करेक्टर विच कंपोज ऑल एजेज एंड नेशन डिस्कस और चौसर्स करेक्टर आर इंडिविजुअल एज वेल एज टाइप डिस्कस आंसर चौसर इज द पास्ट मास्टर इन द आर्ट ऑफ करेक्टर पोर्ट्रेयल हिज prologue is a gallery of character portraits, the greatest of Chaucer's portraits. Within the body of a tale is that of the friar in the Sumner's tale, but is the poem as a whole Chaucer's masterpieces of characterization are the Pardoner and the Wife of Bath. Both lay bare their very selves. The Pardoner offers a cynical disclosure. This is pitiless in its realism and daringly outspoken. The Wife of Bath is immoral, like Falstaff and Rebellionism before rebellion. She lets herself go with a gusto and a frankness as can disclose her views on marriage and her own successive marital exploits. The Wife of Bath is the greatest of them all. Chaucer delight in her creation. Nothing else is quite like her. His self-revelation with its verse and its raciness is superb. The Pardoner is the one lost soul. A professor Kitter calls him among the pilgrims without a single sharp moment of revulsion, and the tale he tells is a sermon on avarice, a sermon full of fragrant cynicism. This tale of greed and death closes with the most haunting of all personification of death. Then the Pardoner offers, disregarding his confession, his self discredited pardon for sale, and his relics to kiss, and impudently signals out of the host. That is the most repugnant moment of the journey. The entire delineation is dramatic. Chaucer is the great painter of character in English literature. In the prologue to the Canterbury Tales, the 30 pilgrims whose portraits Chaucer has traced give us an excellent idea of the society of that time. Except for royalty and aristocracy and the robbers and tramp or outcast, he has painted the entire English nation. He leaves out the highest and the lowest. The 30 pilgrims, including the host, belong to diverse professions. A gentle blood is seen in the knight and his son. They represent the warlike element. The learned and liberal profession are represented by the man of law, the doctor, the Oxford clerk, and the poet. The merchant and the shipman come from the higher commercial community. The Wife of Bath, an expert clothmaker, haberdasher, and his associates belong to the class of smaller London traders and manufacturer. Agriculture has the ploughman, the miller, and the franklin. The upper servant like municipal and reeve, and the lower servants like the yeoman and the cook represents the town and country. The monk from his monastery, the prioress from her convent, her attendant priests, the village person and the roaming friar, the Pardoner and the Sumner cover the religious orders. These portraits strike a balance between character and the individual. They preserve the typical qualities of the one and the idiosyncrasies of the other. Chaucer had an actual rogue John Holy of Dartmouth in the back of his mind when he drew the shipman, but in the course of his portrayal he ceases to be John Holy with one line alone. With many a tempest headed his bird been second, Chaucer makes us recognize him in very age and every clime. The 30 characters are true to the mold in which all human nature is cast. Some of them seem to be living even today. The old knight can be found in every generation, the squire half dandy half athlete is the typical young man of any day. The merchant's pompousness comes from the accumulation of riches. The man of law piles up fees and land. We recognize in him the typical liars of today. Now her so busy a man as he thereness, and yet he seemed busier than the boss. The doctor uses medicines in the bay, we know full ready headed. He is apothecaries to send him drogers, and his liturgies for each of them made other for the win. Her friendship was not new to begin. He is a man of science, his studies was but little on the Bible. More general traits would have turned the picture into a frozen symbol, an uninteresting abstraction. More individual traits would have confessed it by depriving the mind of obvious means of identification. Legois, it may also be added here that the character of Chaucer's pilgrims are the characters which compose all ages and nation. Some of the names or title are altered by time, but the characters themselves remain unaltered, and constantly they are the physiognomies or lineaments of universal human life. Black, the very perfect gentle knight, is dressed in bar-like customs, and a gay young squire is embroidered by he as it were a midi, all full of fresh flowers, white and red. Sing he was of floating all the day, it he was a fresh as is the month of May. The merchant with his forked beard is dressed in motley and sits high on his horse with a flan-dryer dress, beware that hat. The poverty of the clerk and his unworldliness are this given. As lean was his horse as is a rack, and he has not right fat, I undertake, but looked holy and there too soberly full thread where was his overrest curtpy, for he hadn't gotten him yet ni benefit. Nay, was so worldly for to have coffee. His love for learning is proved by his being indifferent to Rolf's riches. The beard of the Franklin is as white as Daisy. He is Epicurus, Owen's song rolling in comfort. Chaucer looks at his character objectively and delineates each of the men and women with care. He describes his characters, noticing a bright detail here and there. This gives the impression of casualness, economy, significance, and variety of every detail. These are examples of an art which conceals art. Chaucer does not follow any definite plan. Sometimes the visual detail of dresses come first. The knight's gipon is still marked by the rust and while from his armor. It is factual information, yet we learn that he has wasted no time while going on his pilgrimage. Chaucer's method was unprecedented. It was for the first time that a writer thus portrayed individual and ideas. The characters are consistent and they grow and develop like real living human beings. They reveal themselves but their own words and action. The best example is to be found in Master Harry Bailey. His character is gradually revealed to us in the pilgrimage in a series of threats. In the Canterbury Tales, Chaucer has given us a picture of the 14th century social and religious conditions. Having a deep and lively interest in life and gifted with a keen power of observation, he describes his characters realistically. The characters represent different professions and they reflect the varied aspects of life. The most important event of the 14th century was the Black Death, which visited England 4 times, 1/2 of the population, including 2/3 of the inhabitant of the capital, had been killed. Chaucer thrown some light on the helplessness of medical science. In all the world, there was none like his doctor. He was a very perfect practitioner, yet the basis of his scientific knowledge was astronomy. He was most careful about money and he collected it in sufficient quantity. During the pestilence, he kept that he won pestilence for gold. In physics is a cordial, therefore he loved gold. Age special, in special the 14th century England had a number of great landed proprietors and worthy bevassers, smaller landowners who, like Chaucer, Franklin, a very Saint Julian of hospitality, never knew what it was to be without back mint. In the house where their tables dormant in the hall away stood ready covered all the long day, extravagance in dress was prevalent in those days. The love of display is shown in several characters. The knight's horses are decked out with more finery than is the knight himself, with curious harness as in saddles and bridles, crupers and breastplates covered with precious clothing and with bars and plates of gold and silver. The wife of Bath wanted to be seen as well as to see herself. Her kerchiefs were full fine of texture and weighed 10 pounds. That on Sunday were upon her head, her hosen to wear of fine स्कारलेट रेड फुल स्ट्रेटी टाइड एंड सूज फुल मॉइस्ट एंड न्यू अपॉन एन एम्ब्रे जी इजीली सी सेट वाई बिम्पल्ड बेल एंड ऑन हेयर हीड एंड हेट एज ब्रूड एज इज ए बॉकलर और ए टार्ज दस चौसर्स आर्ट ऑफ करेक्टराइजेशन इज एट वंस पिक्चर स्क्वीज रियलिस्टिक एंड इमेजिनेटिव। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन है चौसर प्रोलॉग इज ए गैलरी ऑफ कलरफुल पोर्ट्रेट्स डिस्कस और टिस सफिशियंट टू से अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोवर्ब्स दैट हेयर इज गॉड्स पेलेंटी। हाउ फार डज दिस स्टेटमेंट अप्लाई टू चौसर्स प्रोलॉग टू द कैंटरबरी टेल्स। आंसर चौसर्स प्रोलॉग टू द कैंटरबरी टेल्स इज ए वंडरफुल पोर्ट्रेट गैलरी अबाउट विच इट मे बी सेड दैट हेयर इज गॉड्स प्लेंटी हिज पिलग्रिम्स आर लाइक 29 पोर्ट्रेट्स हंग ऑन ए बाल। चौसर लाइक ए ट्रू पेंटर पेंट्स इन वर्ड्स देयर ड्रेसेस हैबिट्स पेक्यूलरिटीज लाइक द डिसलाइक विथ ए रिमार्केबल विविडनेस एंड डेक्सटेरिटी। द मोस्ट स्ट्राइकिंग फीचर्स ऑफ द प्रोलॉग इज दैट हेयर द पोएट प्रेजेंट्स ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ करेक्टर्स रिप्रेजेंटिंग देयर क्लासेस बट एट द सेम टाइम एंडोव्ड विद देयर इंडिविजुअलिटीज। दीज करेक्टर्स आर नॉट मेयर कर्व्ड इमेजेस बट लिविंग क्रीचर्स। दे स्ट्राइक द लीडर्स इमेजिनेशन बाई देयर वेराइटी एंड डाइवर्सिटी। फॉर दिस कंटेम्पररी टेल्स चौसर सिलेक्टेड करेक्टर्स फ्रॉम ऑलमोस्ट ऑल वॉक ऑफ लाइफ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द नाइट एंड द यंग स्क्वायर एंड द ह्यूमन आर देयर रिप्रेजेंटिंग द ओल्ड ट्रेडिशन ऑफ चिवलरी। द नाइट इज एन एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ द आइडियल्स ऑफ चिवलरी थ्रू एन ऑनर फ्रीडम एंड करसी बट हिज इंडिविजुअल फीचर्स मेक हिम एज मीक एज हिज एज इज ए मेड। द यंग स्क्वायर आल्सो रिप्रेजेंट्स द ट्रेडिशन ऑफ हिज फादर बट ही इज आफ्टर एयर ऑल ए यंग मैन हु वाज फ्रेशेस एज इन इज द मंथ ऑफ मे ही कैन कंपोज सॉन्ग्स एंड सिंग देम टू द ह्यूमन इज ए ट्रू फॉरेस्टर। द इक्लेस्टिकल क्लास इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई द मॉन्क द प्रायोरेस द पार्टनर द समनर एंड द पर्सन। द हंटिंग मॉन्क हैज एन अल्ट्रा मॉडर्न आउटलुक फॉर हिम। द टीचिंग्स ऑफ एस्टी मोर एंड एस्टी बेनेडिक्ट आर आउट ऑफ डेट। He does not believe in the rule that ordained the monk to remain within his cloisters and not to indulge in hunting. In his dress and appearance, the monk is a worldly man with the finest grey fur embroidered on his sleeves. His hood is fastened with a chain of gold. He is fat lord with a shining greasy face. The prioress is pleasant tender hearted but full of affections in her manners. Her smile is full simple and coy. She can sing her service divine in a nasal tone. She is very careful about table manners but at the same time she is highly sentimental. The partner represents that cynical class of exploiter with doubtful qualification who speculates and lives richly on popular superstitions. He has no conscience and can top down to the meanest level for petty gains. The Sumner is even worse than the partner. He argues that a man's soul is in his purse, for it is in his purse that he is punished. The Sumner thrives on the misfortunes of others, but the Blaze person is an exception. In this picture gallery, in the words of Sketch Chaucer, in his description of the person, contrast the pity and industry of the secular clergy with the bigness and laziness of the religious order of rank. The person of Chaucer, unlike other persons, is rich in thought and deed. He shows that example is better than percept. Beside these ecclesiastical characters, there are also the friar and the clerk Oxford. The friar is represented as a cunning beggar who knows the art of inducing the woman to give him money and gift. He likes to have acquaintance with the rich rather than the poor and the sick. But the clerk is a devoted scholar who is not at all materialistic. He shows all the novelty in his behavior. He would gladly learn and gladly teach. Then there are portraits of men from various professions. The miller, a stout earl for the nuns, is shouldered broad and a thickly set person. He can very well steal corn and charge thrice. The municipal is a careful purchaser who can befool a number of liars. The reeve is an efficient accountant who can receive thanks and gift from his lord by lending him his own money. The doctor is well versed in his science. He knows the cause of every disease and also its remedy, but he works for the benefit of his apothecary. He has a special love for gold and made great fortune during pestilence. The shipman, wearing a gown of coarse stuff, can drive wine repeatedly and in plentiful measure from the cask. While the merchant slept, he is little bothered about a scrupulous conscience. The cook is an efficient person in his field. The sergeant of the law, who has acted as a justice very often, has good knowledge of case since the time of King William. He knows how to make up a case so that nobody can find faults with his draft. Among the women beside the prioress, there is the portrait of the wife of Bath. Her picture is quite unforgettable. She is a good cloth maker. She has visited many places of pilgrimage in her youth. She has had several lovers, and so far she has married 5 times. She is gap-toothed and has got large hips. She wears scarlet stocking but carries a heavy weight of kerchiefs on her head on Sunday when she goes to the church. Thus it may be observed that Chaucer portrays his men and women with a touch of painter. The picture portraits are quite vivid. Chaucer must have been a man of a most wonderful comprehensive nature because as it has been truly observed of him, he has taken into the compass of his Canterbury Tales the very manners and humours, as we now call them, of the whole English nation. In his age, all his pilgrims are severally distinguished from each other, and not only in their inclination but in their very physiognomies and person. Even the grave and serious characters are distinguished by their several sorts of gravity. Their discourse are such a belong to their age, their calling and their breeding such as are becoming of them, and of them only some of his persons are vicious and some virtuous, some are unlearned, so or Chaucer calls them lewd, and some are learned. Even the livelry of the low characters is different. The reeve, the millers, and the cock are several men and distinguished from each other. As much as mincing lady prioress and the bold speaking gap toothed wife of Bath, but enough of this. There is such a variety of game springing up before me, and that I am distracted in my choice and know not which to follow. 'Tis sufficient to say, according to the proverbs, that there is God's plenty. Dryden Kinsler. Thanks, best of luck.